Welcome to Breakthrough. Thank you for joining us. Be sure to click the subscribe button followed by the bell icon so you don't miss any future videos.
Easy. I say that word. When I say that word, I know you're thinking it's not easy. It's not easy. And often as a Christian, we go, it's just too difficult to be a Christian. You know, I have to have faith. I gotta struggle with what I think I know and the truth in me and the truth that God is feeding me into my word, in the word of God. The word of God is truth. And then when I take that in, it replaces something I believe is true. And it causes me to go to a place that's uncomfortable, to a better place. I know it's going to be better, but it's just not comfortable right now. And so you say, well, it doesn't sound too easy. And I'm going to tell you, it doesn't sound easy, but to do nothing is not easy either. Because I'm going to tell you, in my life, if I do nothing, things don't get easier, right? Things don't just fix themselves. I end up in a worse place because if I stop today, right now, I will slide backwards. I will go right back to where I came from, and or a worse place because I stop believing. I turn my back on what God has done in my life, and we can't do that. We must continue to go forward. I'm going to tell you that the simplest thing to do, though, is to listen to what God is saying, right? Don't just sit there and you know, life is just not easy, okay? You have to make a decision, though. You have to make a choice. And Philippians 4, verse 13, one of our very famous verse in all of the Bible, right? I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, right? My strength comes from Christ. He's the one that is going to show me how to do life, right? He's the one that's going to take me. So my strength is in Christ, so I can do life, right? I can do life. But maybe you can relate with me, right? I've been doing life for over five decades. Okay, that sounds really, I sound really old when I say it like that. But I understand that if I plant a seed, right, today, I cannot go out tomorrow and expect to reap a harvest. I can't go out and pick an apple. If I plant an apple tree tonight, I can't go out tomorrow and get an apple off that tree. Matter of fact, it hasn't even started to grow yet. The process has only begun. And often in our life, we think that we should be able to plant something today and receive a harvest tomorrow. But what God is doing, He's placed something in us, right? If Christ comes to live in our heart, the easy thing is to continue to do what Proverbs 4, verse 23 says. It says, guard your heart with all diligence, for out of it flow the issues of life. It's easy to understand that if God is in me, if the truth is in me, it's going to come out of me at some point. Something's going to grow. Something's going to change. My attitude is going to change. My heart's going to change. My what I look at is going to change. What I speak about will change. Who I hang around with is going to change. All of those changes are going to happen, and they're going to happen easy because I'm going to fall in love with Jesus, and I'm going to walk towards Him, and He's going to be my God and my shepherd, and He's going to take me to places that are uncomfortable. Yes, because the old man must pass away. All things have to become new. That's part of the process of letting God come out of my life. Amen? It's easy because it's in the DNA of the seed. Come on. When the seed goes in the ground, I don't get to program the seed. The seed already is programmed. So whatever I plant, it's going to grow. If it's a tomato or whatever it is, that's going to grow. It's in the DNA. So if Jesus comes into my life, what comes out of my life is going to be, right, good. Amen? Because God is good. If I said that to you right now, if I said God is good, you would say God is good. And all the time, God is good. God is good all the time. He's just good. We all understand that. But the Word of God is truth, and it does good things in me. It takes me to a place that I've never been, and it's going to be uncomfortable. But it is easy because I can trust that whatever that looks like is going to be good. Amen? Good is good. All right? There's this great verse, and I'm running out of time. But in 2 Corinthians, actually, let me give you two verses. I just want to connect two verses real quick. Galatians 6, verse 7. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap. And then let's connect with that. 2 Corinthians 9, 6. He that soweth sparingly shall reap sparingly. Okay? God is not mocked. So when we sow seed, guess what? Something's going to come up. Amen? God is not mocked. It's powerful when you think about it. We want to control the outcome of every situation, but the real control is in the seed, okay? And God is saying, I'm God, I made the seed, right? I know what the harvest will be. Amen? That's so true. It's so true right there. Because if we're sowing good seed and it's in good ground, good things will come out of it. Amen? That's really powerful. And I like the word mock. I don't have enough time, but if I could dissect that word mock. Mock is really teasing, right? It's like I'm tempting God with the outcome of something that he already knows is going to happen, all right? He's God. He's God. He made the seed. Amen?